All right, I hope you guys are ready for one more dish. And this time it's a sweet ending to our cocktail soiree. So we're gonna make a little bit of a dessert canapé, and I'm sure that Aliona of Speakeasy will prepare some perfect cocktail to go with our dessert. So I'm calling it Eau Claire's. So, you know, it's like, well, it's not really that creative of a name. I mean, it's basically a combination of Eau Tup and Eclair. Oh, so, that's why it's Eau Claire.
Well, clever.
I will take applause anytime now. No, I'm just kidding. So, we're going to start with pastry cream. We're going to start by boiling up some whole milk. We're using whole milk because we're actually boiling the milk. So, if you're using something a little bit less, like let's say a 2% or a skim milk, that actually doesn't go as well, yeah. And sometimes it kind of breaks. So that's why we use whole milk. And this one, we're just going to flavor it with a little bit of banana extract. Actually, it has a pretty strong odor, so we're only gonna add about a drop or two. We're just gonna wait for this to boil, and meanwhile, I'm gonna get a mixing bowl, and to this, we're going to add in some egg yolks, so a couple of egg yolks. And if you're using a large egg, you can probably survive with two. And if you're using medium-sized eggs, then you probably want to use about three. We're also going to add in about 50 grams of sugar. So this is just regular white sugar. And we're also going to add in some flour. So I'm going to add in about 25 grams of flour. So we're just going to mix this up. And right now it looks a little bit like a dry roux or like a dough, like the beginnings of a dough. And we're going to pour in our boiled milk into this, and then we're gonna cook it again. So that's basically your pastry cream, and it's the cream that you add in for your eclairs, for your cream puffs, and a host of other things. Selena, help me out.
When you make Saint Honoré, you know the little choux that you pile up, you can do that as well. That's yummy.
That is
and
awesome.
That's the simplest thing to do as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, simple for you guys, maybe. So we're just going to, okay, so the milk is about to boil, so you don't really want to a full boil, just a little bit on the edges here.
Okay.
Actually, all it does is just make sure that when you mix this in, you cook a little bit of the eggs, right? Just a little bit. So I'm gonna have you guys mix this.
Oh.
I'm gonna pour in just a little bit of the milk first. So what we wanna do is actually just temper it a little bit, right? So you add in a little bit of the milk because it's super hot, and then just make sure that the eggs don't cook, right? Because you don't really want scrambled eggs in your dessert. So we're gonna add in a little bit more of the milk. And what's gonna happen is it's slowly gonna mimic the temperature of the milk here, right? And that way the eggs don't really overcook.
So I think unlike the yema, actually the flour is gonna try and make it thicker. So you'll have a smoother sauce.
Tracy, looks like you did a great job.
Thank you.
And there's always a job waiting for you at Quirky Bacon. No, I'm just kidding.
As the mixer.
So we're just gonna pour that back in. And we're gonna cook this over low heat. We're just going to cook it until it thickens. Okay, so the key here really is you wanna make sure that you mix as it thickens up, just to make sure you don't get any lumps and you get that smooth sauce that Selena was saying. So after this, it's pretty much very simple. We're just gonna put the pastry cream on top of our Eau Tup, and then we're gonna add in some saba and then a little bit of chocolate. So it's already thickening, and you just wanna make sure that you take it a little bit away from the heat if it gets a little bit too thick for you.
Mm-hmm. How about when you're cooking it, should it be like a non-stick pan?
Actually, no, you don't need a non-stick pan, but if you do have one, it might actually make things a little bit easier for you in terms of cleanup.
Yeah.
But in terms of cooking, it shouldn't be a problem. Remember, as it cools, it's also going to thicken up some more. Mm-hmm. So we're going to stop the cooking right here, and we're just going to let this cool off. Okay, so we're gonna use the Eau Tup as our vessel. Eau Tup is a really nice flaky pastry. I think it's a good contrast because you have that really mushy pastry cream, right? And then you have the really crispy bottom. Mm-hmm. And then we're gonna add in some caramelized saba on top. So we're gonna set up our assembly station right here. So we're first gonna need one Eau Tup. So we're just gonna add a little bit of our pastry cream, and then we're gonna top that with some very ripe saba. A little bit of sugar, and then we're just gonna torch it.
Hold up. I heard the word torch, and I noticed earlier that Marco was the whipper, Tracy was the mixer, and Celine gets to approve everything you do.
Uh-huh.
I wanna roll.
You can watch.
You can.
And I'm the watcher.
You know we're at Speakeasy, right? We're not at my place, so I can't really risk you doing the torching. You're gonna do the rest of the torching. I'm just gonna show you one, and you want a really nice dark color on the bananas. There you go. And then we're going to finish it off with just a touch of bitterness with our tablea chocolate. All right, so we've got our dessert right here, but of course, we're not going to be satisfied with one piece, right? So I'm going to go ahead and make some more. Our master matchmaker, Aliona, has prepared a drink called Captain's Cookie to go with my eclairs. Using a coffee siphon, she brewed a nippy combination of rose tea, vanilla pods, and some citrus zest, spiked with sweet syrup, then tempered with boiling water. Now add star anise for an aromatic touch you can't resist. All right, guys, for dessert, we've got a really cheeky combination here. So we've got the eau claires, and then we have Captain Cookie. So they should go really great together. Wow, it smells really good.
It smells so good.
I made it, guys. I'm just kidding.